We want to solve the system of equations using the substitution method, which is an algebraic method for solving a system. The solution to a system of equations is an ordered pair, or x and y value, that satisfies both equations. So to keep things organized, let's call this equation 1 and this equation 2. The first step in the substitution method is to solve one of the equations for one of the variables. Notice if we look at the first equation, we can pretty easily solve this equation for x just by adding 4y to both sides of the equation. So let's start by doing that. So here we'll add 4y to both sides of the equation. This would be 0, so now we have x equals 4y minus 8. The second step is to use this equation and perform substitution into the other equation, or in this case, equation 2. If we know x must equal 4y minus 8, we can substitute 4y minus 8 into the second equation for x. So by performing this substitution, equation 2 would be 3 times, instead of x, we'd have 4y minus 8 plus 8y equals 24. And notice how now we have an equation with one variable. So now we'll solve this equation for y and then perform back substitution to determine x. So the first step here is to distribute. So we'll have 12y minus 24 plus 8y equals 24. Here we have two y terms. 12y plus 8y would be 20y. So we have 20y minus 24 equals 24. Now we have a basic two-step equation, so we'll add 24 to both sides. Here we have 20y equals 48, and now we'll divide both sides by 20. So we have y equals, this would be 48/20. But this does simplify. These both have a common factor of 4. 48 is 4 times 12, and 20 is 4 times 5. These 4s simplify to 1, and we're left with y equals 12/5. Now remember, the solution consists of an ordered pair, or an x and y value. So now we know that y is going to be 12/5. But we still have to go back and determine the value of x. To do this, I think we'll use the form of equation 1 that's already solved for x. So using equation 1 and y equals 12/5, we would have x equals 4 times y, or 4 times 12/5 minus 8. So we can think of this as 4 over 1, but nothing's going to simplify here, so we're going to have x equals, this is going to be 48/5 minus, then here we can think of 8 as 8 over 1. We know we have to have a common denominator, so we'll multiply this by 5 over 5. So we'd have 48/5 minus, this would be 40/5. Which is equal to 8/5. So we know the value for x must be 8/5. So here we have one unique solution. X is equal to 8/5 and y is equal to 12/5. So we can also say that this system is consistent and the equations are independent. Normally it's a good idea to go back and perform substitution to check these solutions in both equations. But I'm not going to show that for this example. You may want to just to verify them.